fifth year at Cannes.
Yes.
I can hardly believe it. It feels like we just talked and you were just here and we were like, oh my God, you're going to make your debut. So what have you learned over the past 4 years that you're applying to this year?
You know, honestly, it's about having a good time. I like I keep saying every year that if my film was, showcasing or was in competition and I had to do, then I would be ridiculously nervous. Because, you know, like you said, the critics are scary
they're
here.
Brutal. Yeah, they boo.
But I just have to, right now, I just have to look pretty, walk the red carpet, go
comes
for parties.
Effortlessly.
No, I don't know if it's effortlessly, but, you know, I don't take myself too seriously. And I'm doing it for my brand, who I'm really proud to be associated with. And I'm just going to be there, wear a beautiful dress, watch a great film, and go to a party and come back.
But, you know, I'd interviewed Eva Longoria a couple of years ago, and she said, it's not as easy as it looks. It takes a village to do this, does it?
Yes, of course it does. I've always said that. I was like, this is not how I wake up in the morning. This is really not how I wake up in the morning. I've been stitched and prepped and moisturized and made up and sprayed to death and that's how I look like this.
So we're of course talking about you as this fashion diva and this fashion guru, but I can see the bruises on your arm from shooting Nija. What is going on?
So my idea a couple of years back, right before I signed Ranjana, was to do films that push me beyond a certain point, and so I can like keep bettering myself with every film and do something different so people don't have typecast me in films. And, we had Aamir Khan coming on set on the first day of Nija and giving us this great pep talk and talking about how great Ram is. And,
Ram
Madhwani, the director of the film. So he had this idea to shoot the film like a documentary. So basically, we never break character. We have the longest takes, like we have 6-hour takes before we break for lunch or use the loo or something like that. But we never break character. So he also wants to shoot the before and after of the scene, you know, and he'll just take certain portions of what we are shot. So Nija was on that plane for 16 hours. So we shoot for 16 hours. So the crease on the clothes, the sweat, the wearing off of the makeup.
It's all real.
It's all real. The tears, the action.
And the bruises.
I can be an air hostess right now. I can serve you tea. I can do the announcements. I can do everything.
But Sonam, is that, how much of a struggle is it for you? Given that you know, you've also done enough of the sort of the more light, the fluffier roles, you know, the
Khoopsura,
the Dolly. Yeah.
But I did a Ranjana and...
But is this the hardest?
No, it's not actually, because you never break character, right? So I'm never on my phone, I'm never distracted. So you get so involved. I started believing I was this person. And it's actually made me better, because she had so much courage and so much... she was so good. There is something about her that I really identify with. This girl was very black and white, you know, extremely principled and very... she just used to leap before she thought, which is a lot like me. But at the same time, she was 22 years old when she died. You know, she died 2 days before her birthday. So I'm just like this. I grew up in Bombay. I don't know if I was 22 and if I had to put myself between bullets and people, and if I had to become the captain of the ship, would I sink with the ship? This girl had the courage to do that. I don't know if I could ever do that, but she had the courage to do that. So I feel like I had a responsibility to work harder to kind of live up to her memory. Otherwise, it's shameful. And if I wasn't honest, I would be ashamed of myself. I didn't want to be chewing gum and being on the phone. And
You don't want to be flippant about it.
I don't want to be flippant about it. I usually don't take myself seriously in terms of a lot of things, but certain things you need to be responsible for. And this is one of those things where I'm just like, I don't know what people will say, but I've been 5,000% honest where this role is concerned. I never want to question myself and be like, okay, I didn't do justice to this girl's memory.
So do you hope, Sonam, to be here someday with a film like that?
You know, honestly, I don't know about that.
Is that an aspiration since you've been coming here now for?
What I aspire for, honestly, is for Indian films to kind of be more recognized and taken more seriously. And especially the bigger films, the more commercial films, you know, you have Like, for example, I honestly feel like a Munna Bhai would have been a great entrant for CAN. Not because it is a reflection of what India is, and at the same time, it's great content. Or, for example, A Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara. You know, because CAN is not only about the small films, it's also about the films that represent India, sure. I would say represent their country.
A little window into that world.
Yeah, like Iranian films, or if you look at, you know, there's a representation of that country. So, you know, all the smaller films, which are brilliant, some of the ones that have been in competition have been showcased here, but they are a minuscule part of what the industry is actually all about. You know,
so you want to see more mainstream stuff coming in?
Yeah, which has great content. I'm not talking about,
sure,
you know, I mean, you can never doubt that a Munna Bhai or a Zindagi or you know, some of the good